yeah. What's up, guys? I have on my hoodie. Everybody. Wow. Wow. Today's the day, y'all. That, of course, is Big Time Rush's boyfriend. Huge hit. Huge song. Alright, I'm obviously very excited about today. I've been getting some, like, stuff ready for this chat today, and it's really taken me back down memory lane. So, without further ado, I'm going to bring in my guest today, Kendall Schmidt. All right, see if he's here. He is. Come on, Kendall.
I'm here.
Here we go.
I still remember some of the moves.
Yeah, was that like the carnival episode or something?
Yeah, that the actual TV show version.
Right.
Was the carnival. And then I think, you know, we always had different choreography for everything. You know, we were always like, always learning. Remember, we would have scenes and then we'd have to duck out and go learn choreography and the whole thing.
Yes, because you guys would shoot music videos at the same time as the episode.
Yes.
Wow.
It was a lot.
Yep. It's all coming back to me now.
Woo! And it's all coming back to me.
Okay, so I don't think you really need an introduction, but this is Kendall Schmidt, everyone. We were on Big Time Rush together. I texted you a picture of this jacket before we went on, and I was like, are you ready? Because
I have some stuff too.
This is all in like a Big Time Rush box or something in the garage, so... Anyway.
I have a box as well.
Yeah, we all have a box.
Yes.
Yeah, so today is a really big day, because, you know, this is what the people have been wanting.
Got to give the people what they want.
And so...
Check this out.
Woo-hoo-hoo! Wow. Look at that. Look at those hunks, all of them.
Hunky hunks.
Hunky, hunky. Carlos, Logan, James, Kendall.
That's right.
That's right. So, yeah, so we did Big Time Rush together on Nickelodeon, and I think it's safe to say it really was some of the best times of our life thus far, right?
Yeah, yeah. I think back to it a lot.
Yeah.
I had a lot of fun. I know everybody had a lot of fun. It was a lot of work. We worked really hard. So it wasn't, you know, like, it didn't just happen. We made it happen.
And I was thinking about it too, because I was like, trying to think of like, oh, when did, like, how did I get cast? Like, what was it like at the beginning? And it made me remember that there was another version of Big Time Rush.
Yeah.
Right? And
yeah,
then
there was.
And you weren't in it, right?
No. So the pilot episode, first of all, the character names were different.
Right.
They were actual character names. And there was a different guy, Kurt Hansen, who has gone on to have an illustrious Broadway career.
Yes. Absolutely.
Killing it. And dude's got a smile. I tell you what, he's got a smile. Have you seen him lately?
I don't think so.
He looks the same.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
He didn't age.
Yep. Good for him.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah,
honestly,
there was.
I look the same too, except my hair's just like not as like curled.
Yeah.
Right?
You look pretty much exactly the same.
I also haven't aged.
Yes. Yeah.
Anyway, so Kurt was in it.
Yeah.
And then they shot an episode, and I was also in that pilot.
You were, right? But you played the sister.
No, I think I played Joe, but I don't think she was named Joe yet. And, like, my only thing was that I pushed someone in the pool at the very end of the pilot. So, like, mm-hmm. I had a really small part, and they're like, yeah, like, you might come back, you might not. And then it took them a while to, you know, get you in there and get the cast figured out and sort of redo the pilot. So it was like almost a year later for me. And I was like, I don't know if that's even going to come back.
Yeah.
And then it ended up coming back, and I got to be a bigger part of the show than I was maybe ever going to be. I don't know.
I feel like you did play the sister, though. Maybe I'm crazy, but.
Honestly, you could be right. I have a terrible memory.
Yeah. But, you know, you, like, I can't imagine because I wasn't in that position where I booked it and then had to wait. But, right. Like, things coming back around and ending up being better than they were before, like, never happens.
Right. Yeah.
You know?
I can imagine
that you were probably like, this is great.
Yeah.
This is awesome.
I mean, oh, that's still happening? I can come back and, like, be Joe and be in my first episode where you guys were all fighting over me? I mean,
it doesn't really get better than that. It
doesn't really get better than that. So, anyway, I don't have too much of a format to today's episode of IG Live with Caitlin and Friends.
Yeah.
A little bit of a long title. Yeah, yours has a nice ring to it, Coffee with Kendall, and, like, I can't obviously take coffee with Caitlin.
Yeah, no, you can't.
So, that's my top choice.
Yeah, of course. Do you drink coffee?
Yeah, I do.
Okay, good.
Yeah.
Good. If you didn't, I probably wouldn't trust you.
If I didn't, it would have been a real sham of me to come on your show.
You don't have to drink coffee on the show. I used to have the option if you wanted to drink tea, but getting caffeinated is kind of part of the gig, you know? So,
right.
So since there's no format today, I don't want to lead your IG Live with Caitlin Tarver.
No,
show,
please.
But, I don't know if you have any more memorabilia. I have a box of assorted memorabilia that I would like to.
I mean, I have some pictures that I've set aside that I can, you know, show in the chat at some point. And I also came across this like YouTube compilation of Kendall and Joe's relationship timeline.
Oh yeah.
And yeah. I just before I even click play, I just want to show the still that is the cover of the video. Hold on. I don't really know how to
cool
take
that. that's super
it's
good.
It's our beautiful kiss and then also me looking insane, which is accurate. But what memorabilia are you holding on to over there?
What memorabilia am I hoarding?
Yeah.
Okay, so first thing I just pulled up was a what would this be called? This is the days.
It's sides, but it's
they're the days script.
Day of days. No, that's something
else. It's the thing that we had. This is what we had to shoot that day.
Right. So we would get that. Yeah. Someone said a call sheet. I think that's right.
Well, the call sheet's on the front, but the actual, like, the day sides are right here.
Yes, yes.
But anyway, so I want to point something out.
Okay.
My call time that day was 7 a.m.
Okay.
Your call time that day was 11 a.m.
Ah, I thought you were going to say like 5 because usually it was so early for me.
But... And you know which, so this was March 18th, 2010.
Oh my God.
So this is just a little over a year ago. Or a year ago, 10 years ago. I do math.
10 years ago.
10 years ago, and the episode was the 17th episode of the first season.
Oh, wow. So what's
and
the
it was
title?
Big Time Sparks. So we had Jordan Sparks in this episode.
Oh, yeah. I remember that one.
And would you like me to read? Let's see if I can find. Let's see if there's a thing, a script. Which part are you in? So.
Yeah. Well, yeah. Which scene does it take? Because I was thinking it would be fun if we reenacted some of our most iconic scenes together as Kendall and Joe.
Yeah, so let's do, I can, well, I should have sent you this picture before.
We tried to prep.
Yeah, well, you know what? It's all going to be good.
It'll come back to me. Maybe see if I remember.
Let's see. 17, so the first one you're in this day was 17, 19, and 21.
Okay.
Okay, here we go.
Okay. Yeah.
So see if you can.
Kendall is, I'm reading backwards, by the way. Is this your, what's in all caps? And
so
Jordan?
You say, hey guys, this is the guys look down the well. Joe walks up. Hey guys, does anyone know where Kendall is? That's you.
Oh, okay.
So Jordan and I are in the well.
Oh, yeah.
And okay. Action.
Hey, guys, does anyone know where Kendall is?
This is the boys. Nope, no idea. He's not down the well. You look down the well and you say...
I can't tell. It's backwards.
Kendall, is that you and Jordan?
Oh, okay. Okay. So take it from the top. Hey guys, has anyone seen Kendall?
Nope, no idea. He's not down the well.
Kendall, is that you and Jordan?
It's not what it looks like.
I bet I storm off angrily.
Joe storms away.
I tried to give it the Big Time Rush performance. So the beloved creator of Big Time Rush, Scott Fellows.
Yes.
Who we love.
Love Scott.
I don't think he's watching, but if he ever sees this, we love you, Scott.
I sent him one of the pictures you sent me.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, I did.
I should have done that too. But he, you know, he obviously had a very like clear vision of how he wanted it to go. So
yeah.
A lot of times I feel like we do a scene and then he'd come in and be like, all right, let's turn it up like 20 degrees
yeah.
or more. And like, yeah. Then we'd be like, what? And then of course, cause we had to, you know, we had to do everything we could to warrant this sound. I found that on YouTube, just that sound.
You know how, all right, so this happens to me frequently. Like I'll be out and about and I see a group of like people, maybe on average 16 to 20 or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
And like the one that pops in my head, the last time we were getting ice cream before the quarantine thing happened and there
yeah.
was at McDonald's and there was a group sitting eating ice cream.
Yeah.
And Mika and I get our ice cream and we're walking out and right as the door is about to shut on the way out, I hear from the inside, and I always turn, like I always go like,
yeah.
And they go, it's really you. And I'm like, yeah, I mean, of course, you know, you,
right.
Like, I know that noise, but I usually get that as I'm walking away.
Wow. That's good.
I've always made it a rule, like, if somebody says something, I'll absolutely, and I'll go chat and we'll talk about the whole thing and everything.
Yeah.
But if like, so this is, you know, it's this, I'm trying to make this sound like the least pretentious way as possible.
Right. But, I think I know what you're getting at.
Yeah. What I'm saying is if somebody says something, I will totally chat about it and we'll talk and it'll be great.
Yeah.
If someone like stares, you can't like expect me to be like, so hey. I noticed you staring. And yes, it is me.
It is me. Because you know? You run the risk of them being like, what?
Who? Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know who you are.
Have you ever, has this ever happened to you where somebody recognized you from the show and you went and they were like, yeah, just, I love the show. It's so great to meet you. And you're like, yeah. And then of course you instinctually, you're like, well, you want to grab a picture or something? And
right, right.
Has it ever happened to you where they went, no, I'm good.
Probably. I mean, I get a lot of the, like, where it is kind of like that stare. Cause it's like, I think that's that girl. And then I feel like they'll Google, you know, like,
yeah,
you know, and then it'll be like, look at the phone and then look back at me and like in Target or something. And I'm trying to just be like, it's not, they're not looking at me. Cause you know, we have huge egos.
Yeah.
We're like, yes, it's me, Joe. Cause we're insane. And so yes. I'm always like, no, it's not me. And then like, sometimes I'm just like, would it be better if I just am like, hey, yeah. And but because one time it happened to me, I was out somewhere and there was like, I think they still play reruns and stuff.
Yeah. Yeah, of course.
So I think like sometimes even like little kids still are like being introduced to it for the first time. So there was this little girl and she was looking over at me and her whole family was looking over at me. Like, I think it was out at like dinner or something. And I was just kind of like, am I crazy? Or like, are they looking at me a lot? And then I finally was like, hey. And then they were like, oh. And then they came over and they were like, we recognize you from the show. And it was nice because I was like, oh, okay, phew. And it was a little girl, so I didn't feel as like scared if it was like, you know, some.
Can you imagine if they were like, hi.
Hi, what? I mean.
And they're like, you're like, I'm sorry, I saw you staring, and they were like, well, you have broccoli in your teeth.
Right?
You know? And you're like, okay.
Oh, gosh. I just cringe at the thought.
I don't know what this is. Oh, look.
What?
Well, I don't know why it says Lemony Snicket, but this is a hotel. Dearborn, Michigan. I guess maybe I made my like hotel name Lemony Snicket or something like that.
Nice.
But this is a thing, and I'm happy I found this. This is a package of Big Time Rush tickets.
Oh, wow. That's cool.
Rogers Arena.
Oh, my gosh.
Scotiabank Saddle Dome.
Wow.
iWireless Center. This is, what's the date? March. Oh, September 11th, 2012.
Oh, wow.
September 8th, 2012.
How many tours did you guys do?
Like full-on tours. Like I'd say, well, we did the Better With You tour. And then we did the Big Time Summer tour.
Mm-hmm.
And then we did Better With You tour, Big Time tour, Big Time Summer tour. Or summer break tour. It was summer break tour. And I remember we had DJ D-Rec. Remember DJ D-Rec? Was our DJ. And he kept saying during the show, he'd be like, it was summer break tour. And he would say, y'all ready for spring break? Because first of all, nobody says like summer break. Spring break, everyone knows that term.
Right.
You know?
Right.
Summer break isn't like a, it's not.
Right, it's not
way.
Like a phrase.
Not
as much as spring break for sure.
No, spring break. So no, he would say that. This is possibly my favorite piece of memorabilia just because it's something I'd legit wear.
Oh, Big Time Movie.
Big Time Movie, like what kind of jacket is it?
That looks nice.
What company is this? Oh, Arc'teryx. I don't know.
Oh.
It's like a winter jacket, you know?
That's very nice. Let me see if I can get into some of my, keep showing yours, but I'm going to see if I can get to some photos.
Summer tour book of all the dates and like information for the crew and all that stuff.
Is this about to be, you know what? I tried to put stuff in my favorites so I could easily access them, but I feel like the way it does the camera roll, it's like all these pictures are so old. It's all the way at the beginning and I can't like find them. So I'm just going to show them on my laptop.
Oh man, I have an actual photo of us, like a printed photo. That's weird.
Oh really?
Yeah.
Okay, I came across this when I was looking through my old hard drive today and I couldn't believe it. Look.
Oh.
That is Fabio and there's Aaron.
Yeah.
Aaron Sanders, we love you.
You know how many middle-aged women Fabio would be jealous of that photo?
Like, I cannot believe we got to shoot an episode with Fabio.
Yeah, that was pretty epic. You know, Glickman still maintains a good relationship with him.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, that makes sense. Always a cute pic.
That's a nice one. I just found one of us.
Look at that. Look at those smiles. Aww, that's cute. I remember that episode. I think that was the pranks episode.
Yeah, and check this out. Do you have a Big Time Rush scarf?
No.
I think not.
I don't. All I have is this hoodie and this shirt.
This.
Wait, who is that? I mean, I know that's Logan, but.
Let's not worry about that. here's another good one.
Oh, Sierra! Can we talk about how Sierra is cooler than all of us now? I mean, she was cooler then.
Let's not get it twisted.
I know, you're right. No, that's a good clarification. She's always been cooler, but now she's so cool.
She's cool. She's successful. She's talented.
Ugh. We love her.
Ugh, like gross, honestly.
Okay, I found this, and I think I'm also wearing... So this shirt I'm wearing right now, I was wearing in this episode, I don't know, like Big Time Concert or something. There I am. Oh. And Challen and Sierra and you guys and Glickman and Aaron. And it's crazy. I can't believe we shot at the Fonda.
Yeah. Yeah.
So cool.
We shot at the Fonda and we shot at the Avalon for one episode as well.
I remember that. Yes, I remember that. Oh, this is a good one. This is a good, like, example of Scott coming in mid-scene and kind of being like, okay, let's bump it up a little bit. If you can see, this is us where we're shooting a scene. I think the episode where I book a job as Joe and I have to kiss my co-star, Jet.
Yes.
And you get really jealous. And anyway, it's like these fun little scenes with us. But there's Scott being like, Caitlin, if you could just be a little more like, oh, you know, like, oh, really? Because I remember I was putting on chapstick in the scene. And
yeah.
He really wanted me to like move my lips around because it was about how you were like thinking about me kissing someone else.
And it wasn't like do it like sexier. It was like make it like if you were trying to look really stupid.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. I do credit Big Time Rush with like giving me an ability to just look really stupid in front of the camera. And now I feel like I'm really good at it.
You are. Look what I found.
Here's a nice pic. Oh, go. You go. Oh my God.
On the cover of Variety.
On the cover of Variety magazine. Now that is cool.
That's some industry stuff for you.
If you guys know the industry, that's
a big deal, guys.
Here's a cute one of Carlos and I. I think from that.
Look at him.
Look at him.
That's another person who hasn't changed at all.
Love him.
Hasn't changed at all.
Oh, I wish we could find a picture of the Palm Woods set.
Yeah.
Because I do feel like every time someone would, like, my family or, like, a friend would come to set, they'd be like, this isn't outside?
Yeah. Oh, no, it was beautiful. In fact, I think we had the only set where they had dug a pool ever.
Yeah, I mean, the pool was obviously real.
It was a real pool.
I think we all had an episode where we got in there.
Yeah. And there was even some after filming episodes as well.
where
we used the pool as a literal pool party.
Dang it. I don't remember getting the invite to that.
That's weird.
I wonder why.
I figured you would have gotten that. Hey, let's move on. I found this is unrelated to Big Time Rush, but this is 1994.
Okay.
Because I just found this in my memorabilia box, sentimentals box. But look at this.
Wait, I can only see me. Oh my God, is that you?
Yeah, it's me and my brothers.
Look at that.
I'm in my Taekwondo outfit.
Wow.
Of course.
Not a black belt, but a black suit.
No, I was a white belt. And my oldest brother, Kenneth, was a green belt at the time.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, here's probably the best photo of us. Wait.
Yeah, that brings back a lot of really bad memories for me.
I was just going to say, the Halloween episode was... Okay, wait, I also have one of Carlos and I on the Halloween episode where he was Frank and Carlos.
Ugh.
And, okay, so that episode was pretty brutal, especially for you guys. Because that stuff took forever to get into. And we were shooting in the, like, Hollywood Forever Cemetery at, like, all night. And one memory I have, and you might have more, but, like, we were shooting or something. We were very behind. But, like, you know, they have to get the cast ready so we're not waiting on us when the, like, set is ready. It's like, you know, holding. Yes, okay, Sydney's in here. I'm glad. Because my friend Sydney was on set during this episode. And Carlos was, like, having to get into Frank and Carlos, which was a pretty big ordeal. And he was behind, and I was on set because, I don't know, I guess I was shooting or something. And he walks up in full Frank and Carlos and is like, you know, like, okay, when am I going to shoot? And they were like, well, we're running really behind. It's probably going to be about 3 more hours. And he was like, what? You can't just take him out of that costume. Like, he has
to sit there now
in full makeup, full Frank and Carlos. And they were like, we could take you over to Hollywood Boulevard and you could just, like, stand on the sidewalk as Frankenstein and see if anyone wants to take a picture with you.
He might have made some money. You know, if he did that, he might have made a little bit of money.
I know. And we were so delirious. I think that we just found it to be
so
funniest.
Late.
Thing
so
in the
late.
World of just like, if you can get that visual of him, it's not like a great photo of Frank and Carlos, but it's the best I could find. But like him just having to sit in this outfit for 3 hours, being like just sitting there normally, like, but it was just very funny.
It's not a contest, but I'll say that I think I had it a little harder.
Oh, yeah,
because.
I forgot how bad yours was. When I because saw this picture, I was like...
Don't get me wrong. He's got paint on him and he's got, like, stuff. But I had, like, actual hair. And that was a full body, like, the actual body part was a full body werewolf suit that was, like, super thick and hot and itchy. And, by the way, I just want to clarify that it ever sounds like we're bitching on this thing.
Right.
Like, we're not. But the reality is that the suit... itched a lot and it was super
and
hot.
I didn't have to
late.
Wear anything. Look.
Yeah. Yep. You were good.
I was fine.
Do you have the picture of Miss Kendall?
I don't know. Well, that episode was very funny. We have a lot of good looks from that episode.
Yeah.
Big Was it about like where, I don't know if it was, it, our storyline was about how we couldn't be seen together or something, so we would hang out in disguises. And we had a lot of good looks during that. So we'll start with this one, which I actually really thought I looked cute in. Which is a hippie and you as a cowboy.
Yeah. Yep.
Good look. This glare.
Yes, you had a good outfit. That was a good outfit.
Yeah, that was a pretty good hippie outfit. And then this one, I guess I'm a zookeeper and you're a zoo animal. Very subtle, you know, very subtle stuff.
It's a legit animal.
The theme here is I got to look cute most of the time while you looked insane.
Yeah.
This is good.
Are you a flight attendant?
I don't know, I'm a flight attendant and you're like a skier?
Yeah, you're a flight attendant from 1955 and I'm a skier from 1985.
But I was like, oh, look at me as a brunette.
It's good. No, it's good.
Hey, I've never been brunette, so. Wait, and then we have, where is that? Well, I mean, I grabbed this as me as a man.
Convincing.
That was the one time I got to wear a costume that was, you know, funnier. And then us together. Wait, where is it?
You sent it to me.
I know.
Come on, get it together.
All right, I know. Here it is.
Oh, yeah. Yep.
A great one.
Yes. I was not a particularly cute woman.
I don't know. I think you look pretty good.
I also don't know.
Remember this episode where we went to like a premiere or something? I remember liking this look.
Yeah, that's like, for all the things we just showed, that's like a reasonable.
Pretty normal.
Yeah.
Yeah. Kendall and Joe looking normal. Anyway, I don't know. I mean, I have a lot.
By the way, I didn't realize in that the video that you, the link you sent to that Joe and Kendall's chronological timeline or whatever.
Yeah.
I didn't realize. I mean, I know it was kind of like the Kendall look, but I wore so many different versions of check or plaid shirts.
You did. I didn't really realize
it's like
that.
I kind of dressed like a dad most of the time.
I didn't really realize that either. That was definitely your look. It was like plaid. Yeah, plaid shirt. Nice swoop. And then me. Not really sure what I was upset about here.
I also thought when I was watching that video how quickly fashion evolved, because the very first scene where you walk in that they showed in that,
yeah,
first of all, it's not anything like, outfits were really bad.
What?
Both of our outfits were really bad.
Oh yeah, terrible. I mean, this isn't a knock on the wardrobe, it just was like a long time.
No, it was just the times. Yeah. But I would say, I think people could universally agree that 2010, you know,
not
it wasn't a good time for fashion.
No, not the best.
I mean, Lady Gaga was wearing a meat suit, you know?
Yeah. Well, that was pretty iconic, but I don't know. Your plaid shirts were maybe iconic too, now, thinking back.
I've seen some Kendall people dressed up as me for Halloween, and that's usually the go-to.
Really?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, wow. That's huge. Okay, I don't know if this is going to make my connection bad. It might, but I'm just going to go through some of these clips.
Hey, gotta respect a girl with goals.
Oh.
But her so-called boyfriend blows her cover.
This is a pretty good scene.
No, I'm Trenton.
Travis! And you're fired. You set me up.
Well, you lied to me.
I didn't want a boyfriend.
Who says I wanted to be your boyfriend? Because, frankly, I don't like dating girls who lie.
Well, I don't like dating boys who catch me in my lies and make me hire idiot actors who can't remember their names.
Well, then, I guess we're done here.
I guess we are.
Oh!
you want to go to the movies sometime?
Wow. Very sweet. And my side ponytail.
Yeah. By the way, you know what else I noticed? My voice was deeper then.
Okay, see, mine was way higher and yours was way deeper.
I have no idea how that's possible. Like, I had, like, I feel like I have a really high voice now, and my voice was like, well, I didn't want to say it to you today. It's like, what? Why did I sound like that?
Maybe it was higher then, but then you wanted to seem cool and older, so you lowered it.
Yeah, that's probably it.
Also, right. I was looking up some clips. Do you remember the scene where, I don't know what's going on, but there's a good back and forth between us where I go, I think you want Carlos to go out with Candy because you think she's hot. And then you say, do you remember this? I don't want to date a hot girl. I want to date you. and then big reaction from Joe where I go.
Did I say something like, I mean.
No, you say something like, wow, that came out wrong.
Yeah.
It's pretty good. Okay, should we reenact it?
Yeah.
Okay, you remember your line?
I don't want to date a hot girl, I want to date you.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's the joke. Okay, ready? And action. I think you want Carlos to date Candy because you think she's hot.
I don't want to date a hot girl. I want to date you. Wow, that came out wrong.
And scene. The sound effect helps because when I go,
boing.
The sound effect is like, oh God, the sound effects really make the show. I guess that's why they're in there.
Yeah, no, it really does. I feel bad for the editors that have to do
that. Yeah. what else is a good Kendall and Joe moment? This scene is some real drama. Okay, now this was where we really shone. Oh, there's the chapstick scene. Oh, wait, hold on. Let me turn it up.
What does Jet feel the same way about?
Jet, wow, what a great day on set. Joe, I know, BTW, you're a really gifted actor. Jet, I feel the same way about you.
Can we just forget all this ever happened?
Oh, typical!
Typical guy. By the way, what did we learn from that? Never go through your significant other's phone.
Never.
Never do that.
Because you're going to get caught.
Well, because 99% of the time, that's what's going to happen.
Also, if you go through your significant other's phone and you find something, you can't ever say it because then you have to admit you went through their phone.
Hey, so I was going through your personal space and I...
I'm sorry, what? So you gotta
work. I will say, as I'm saying it, like, it's a complicated gray area. I get it.
It is. I agree.
Let's just hope that nobody has to go through that.
I think Kendall and Joe would have learned by now. That was their first brush with, you know, that. And I think they grew from it.
Yeah.
I don't think we should recite that one. I think it's too long.
It's too long. I don't remember it.
I don't either. Oh.
I think you should just forget about me.
Oh, I didn't finish the scene. I just said, I think you should just forget about me. Wow. That's pretty brutal, Joe. And then you leave me a voicemail and you say, I'm sorry. And if you come to the show, I know you'll be. And then I show up to the show. Oh, look how happy you are to see me. Oh, it's
okay. I was also sweaty. I don't know if you noticed
okay,
that.
And now then we get to the real heartbreak scene. Okay, you ready?
This opportunity only comes once in a lifetime.
Maybe you only come once in a lifetime.
Oh, no! Okay, ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Wait, I have to get there emotionally. Wish my hair was as... I'll do my best. Okay. Action.
Action. Okay.
Okay, action.
This is how hard it was to keep a straight face. Right? <Yes. clears throat> Okay. Opportunities like this only come once in a lifetime.
Maybe you only come once in a lifetime. And scene. Oh, wow. I sort of forgot the line. Is it maybe you only come once in a lifetime, or what if you only come once in a lifetime?
Maybe somebody like you only comes once in a lifetime.
Comes once in a lifetime.
Did they really hit the you? Maybe no, Caitlin, really hit the you.
That's true.
Maybe
you only come once in a lifetime. And then wait. Maybe you only come once in a lifetime.
Yeah, yeah.
Commercial.
Yeah.
Oh, that broke everybody's heart.
And they were advertising Polly Pockets.
Yeah, not that old. Oh my god. Okay. And then we have the airport scene, which is devastating. And then, you know, Joe returns to find you kissing Lucy in the elevator, which was tough.
Brutal.
But then you come back to me. Oh, this is the scene we just did.
By the way, I love your face in that scene when you open the door and you see it's me. It has a little bit of like...
I'm still happy
to see you, but like...
Yeah, well, you know I'm still a little mad because the next episode, you can tell I'm not over it.
Yeah.
It doesn't mean smooth sailing for Joe and Kendall.
Okay. There's that awkwardness again.
You think that's awkward? Mm-hmm. Try seeing the boy you never forgot about kiss another girl in an elevator. Then wait around while he takes all day to decide whether he wants you back or not. But they always find their way back to each other.
See? All day? I'm just getting upset thinking about it again. I mean,
yeah.
Gosh, why is it so hard? Okay. I mean, that's, you know, there are some cute clips of us cheersing a corn dog, which I liked. Oh, here's the scene we just did.
How do we do that?
Hold on.
Kendall may not be perfect, but they're perfect for each other. And that's all that matters.
Oh my gosh. Just great, great, great memes.
A lot of good memes.
Well, you know, this has been a nice trip down memory lane. What should we do now?
Well, I have another trip down memory lane if you'd like.
I think
if it's time for that.
I think it might. I mean, what do you think?
Well, I just had low battery. I'm back.
Oh my gosh. Whew. Okay, we better hurry. Maybe I'll do a quick skim of the question box.
Yeah, I'll just plug in my phone. That might work.
Yeah. Maybe it'll give you a second to go. There's so many questions. All right.
Is my audio delayed?
I'm not sure, actually, because I'm looking at the questions.
Oh, okay.
Sorry.
Well, yours isn't.
Okay. wait, where was one? I just saw one. Okay. Would Jendal be married?
Jendal would marry.
Well, would Jendal be married? Would Joe and Kendall be married? I think is the idea.
I suppose the obvious answer would be yes, but I'm trying to think of a reason, like, because it's a TV show, where would the drama come in?
Yeah.
You know, I mean, where would it get complicated?
Maybe there'd be another role that, like, would take me away, and then, you know, they'd grow up. They'd have to hit that time of life where it's like, are we going to settle down or, yeah?
Kind of like the time of life we are in real life currently.
Yes. You know, is everything, is this it? And
yeah,
is how this is going to go?
Is it over?
How old were y'all on the show? I don't know, like 19 to 23 for me, I think.
Oh, I think maybe they mean like our age, our TV ages.
Oh, I don't know how old our characters were.
I want to say the first season we were supposed to be like either like juniors in high school or something like that.
Right.
Or sophomores maybe.
Really?
So
we were that old?
16 starting, maybe 15.
Yeah, I guess so.
At least we didn't have one of those scenes where it was like, what do you want me to do? I'm only 15 years old, you know?
Right. No, I feel like they did a good job of kind of making us ageless, but like in high school, kind of.
Yeah, it only started to get weird when facial hair really started to start growing.
Yeah. Because you guys would go on tour for like 8 months or something.
Yeah.
And then we'd come back to a season and it's like, we'd all look a little bit older. I feel like I came back one time and like was really tan.
There's a scene in that series of clips where you look like you just got back from Cancun or something.
Which I think I did. Like,
yeah.
I think I had gone on vacation and there was an episode and they were like, oh my God.
Yeah, Joe, you were super tan.
Joe was very tan. Okay, who broke character the most? That's tough. You think it was you?
Yeah.
For sure. I mean, between the guys, between like you, Kendall, James, and Logan.
Me, and you.
I was like, you, Logan, James, and Carlos.
Yeah.
Who broke character the most?
Me, 100%.
Yeah. I think
between us, it's probably pretty equal.
Pretty equal, yeah. We were always breaking.
Yeah.
Remember that scene where you're, I think it's in the episode where I'm trying to decide if I'm going to leave or not. And you're like, I think one of your tactics is to go on a date and then you act really gross and like try to get me to break up with you because you're
horrible.
I remember we laughed so much during that
scene. Do you remember Fork Chop?
Yes. I could not keep it together because I'm supposed to be like really upset with you because you're being so insane, but like I just couldn't stop laughing because you're just being so disgusting over there, like, waiter, more drinks, or like something so insane,
like doing this to my belly button or something weird, like
yeah. And then you did Fork Chop and like off screen like the fork would really fly and like,
oh yeah, I cut someone. My hand, remember I cut my hand once or twice doing that too.
You did?
Yeah, like just because the way the tongs were face, you know, they're on the table and you have to,
yeah,
and so if you hit it at the wrong angle you're just, you know.
Yeah, you're gonna get hurt. I mean, we did,
you're gonna get hurt.
We did stunts. Someone just asked, did you do your own stunts in here? I mean,
as much as we could, yeah.
There weren't really like insane stunts, but yeah.
It was like breaking stuff.
Yeah.
Like we broke a lot of things.
We did. There was always just like insanity going on, like pies and llamas on set and having to jump into the pool or this or that. I mean, it was insane.
Just so you know, as far as I'm aware,
we get cut off
in an hour.
Yeah, I know. So we got to wrap this up. All right. Well, Kendall, this has been the best. I'm so glad you came on this trip down memory lane with me. I usually sing a song from my music, but I think today is special. And I think you've prepared something very special for our gentle shippers.
Boy, did I.
So to give you guys a little treat, I've been seeing your comments, and I'm here to deliver. So should we do the same leading up? I don't remember it.
I don't remember it, but just be like,
I think I'm in line. I'm in line at the airport.
You should just react like you were doing in the scene.
I'm waiting in line, and we forgot our goodbye kiss. I think that's
the forgot the goodbye kiss.
Yes.
Mwah.
Mwah, and then, I know. And then you said, and then I say, I gotta go.
I know. And then you walk away, and then this and starts. Then,
okay, ready? So we'll take it from right after the kiss, okay?
Okay.
Okay, action. I gotta go.
I know.
Before you tell me anything, how was your day? Cause I've been missing you by my side. Did I wake you out of your dream? Sorry, but I couldn't sleep. Down there's something about the sound of your voice. I've never been as far away. Soon we'll be together. Pick up right where we left off. Paris, London, Tokyo. It's just one thing that I gotta do. Tuck you in and put on the phone. Tuck you in and I could hardly take another goodbye. Baby, won't be long. You're the one that I'm waiting on. Tuck you in. And I've been thinking about you worldwide. I've been thinking about you worldwide. I've been thinking about you.
And I'm off to New Zealand. Oh, yeah, that was beautiful. Took me right back to the Ontario airport at 6 a.m.
Oh, yeah, long drive.
Oh, my God, that was great. I hope you guys enjoyed that, Kendall. I asked him to do that, and he just so happily obliged. But we truly do love all of you guys watching this for being such big fans of the show and us. We have such great memories of doing this together and really just jump at any chance we can take this trip down memory lane, I feel like.
Oh, yeah. Anytime.
So, Kendall, I hope you're doing all right.
Yeah, we're doing great. I hope you're doing great.
And thanks again for coming on the show. The show. my big Instagram live show. But this has been super fun. Oh, I just saw my mom said hi, Kendall.
Hey, Mama. Hey, so I get paid for this, right?
Yeah. Just send me your invoice, and I'll definitely get on that right. Very quick. I'll have my production office team deal with it.
Okay.
This is a very big operation, so.
Okay.
Anyway, all right. Thanks, Kendall. I'll talk to you soon.
Talk to you soon. Call me anytime.
Anything. All right, bye.
Bye.
Oh, yeah. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed that. That was super fun. Kendall Schmidt, love him so much. And we love Kendall and Joe. Never forget. All right. Well, I'll be back next week with some more. I'll be announcing who my guests are soon. And I'll obviously be saving this for 24 hours. So come back and watch it. But yeah, thanks for tuning in, guys. And going on that beautiful journey with us. That was super fun. Hope everyone has a good Friday and a good weekend. I hope everyone's hanging in there and doing okay. And I will come back and do this again soon. So be looking out for the schedule, more guests, more fun on Instagram Live, on my big show. All right. Thanks, guys. Have a good one. Talk to you soon.